Mr. Amit Yadav, I think the force behind creating telecom policy in the country, along with his leaders and other extremist speakers on dais. Ladies and gentlemen, and a very warm welcome, good afternoon to you. It's like, you know, I always come to this kind of forums. I told TV many times that it took 20 years to be on the dais in the first time in the day, talk about what fiber can do wonders. I think we spoke about in the morning what Amitabh said is that fiber highways is going to make aspirational villages to happen. I think Madam Maruna spoke about how a digital transformation in the country can pump in $1.2 trillion of economy into the country like India. And we have Mr. Faruqi talking about all of this is fine, but we need to monitor it through some indexing. Otherwise, we speak a lot of stuff. So when I think look at all of this, I just wanted to bring few aspects. I think it always usually happens. I get a chance up to Jio, and Jio plans a lot and gives very less time for execution of network. So it's the same story today. So I'll live up to my expectations. And I think as we all know, we are living in an information age. I just want to touch some important aspects for as an industry to really take it forward. An information age, which is actually communication technologies are trying to, I think, not only address the connectivity and knowledge, but also I think it's influencing largely the cultures across globe. I think this is a very wonderful thing that we can actually look at how technologies are actually influencing lifestyles of future generation. That's where I think there is a lot of, I think, revolution is possible in communication industry. The first step towards that would be, I think, talking about telecom networks moving to digital networks. I think both Government of India and some of the telcos, large telcos in India, actually leading that path. That transformation is something which is very vital for the success of what all we spoke since beginning. But it's not going to happen unless we go back and say what happened in the last two decades in the country. What are we going to do differently in the next two decades? It's very important to understand that. I'll just bring some analogy here that if you look at 2000 to 2010 and 2010 to 2018 or 20, there are two decades of two different types of, I think, situations were before us. Between 2000 and 2010, it was basically the major motive was connecting people. So voice has become the prime driver for it. So as technologies just evolved to support that. And we see, I think, as Mr. Amitabh said, today we have about some million kilometers of network, but about a million kilometers of network was deployed in that era, which is about 10 years between that time. What it impacted society? I think it has just made basic lifestyles, basic needs achieved. There is nothing great in that era. Just communication through voice, there is no life-changing experiences. Of course, as Mr. Rajat told, Dr. Rajat told, that's where I think teledensity really kicked up. We were almost non-existent as a telecom sector. We got into 25% teledensity in that area. I think taking that cue, I think last 10 years, we find that something interesting happening. I think it's not, people are now looking at, it's not basic needs anymore. We're talking about life-changing experiences. And I think both private and public joined together to say, can this happen? As a result, we see voice and data. I think data predominantly is taking the prime driver for bringing that impact. And that's the impact we see from most of the speakers talking about. It's not just connectivity anymore. It is basically a means to achieve economic development of the country. And we have seen a lot of numbers that everyone spoke about how a broadband penetration will impact country's economy. So many statistics. But the bottom line is that this is something which happened at a time when something is also happening for the next future demands are. It's very important to know that every month on month, I think some of the large telcos have played a very important role in making this whole revolution happening in the communication digital sector. We are seeing that users are getting added double, getting double every month. We see it sometimes devices are getting added every month. Data per consumer is changing rapidly. Data is a new way of, I think, looking at. While all these are happening, let's look at last 2-3 years. Is it India really grown? There's a lot of ambition, a lot of dreams before us. But we realize that on any statistics we find, we are not there with the global averages, be it with the connectivity part. The fiber deployed per capita compared to China and US, I think many speakers spoke about China would be the new avatar of the technology. And if they are leading this path, India has to learn a lesson from that. I think still a long way to go on that. If you look at any other statistics, whether it is broadband penetration, whether it is speed of broadband, we are trying to catch up, but we are too far from the global measures. I think if you look at why is this situation, despite the realization for last 5 years that we need to create infrastructure in the country for making the country economically develop, there are 2-3 things comes to my mind which are very important to bring to notice of both industry as well as there is somewhere there is lack of coordination happening. Even today, I think there is a lot of focus on how national digital communication policy can bring a connectivity and pump in economy at $1.2 trillion into the economy in India. But there has to be a more collaborative collaboration between public and private. And unfortunately, still, I think government considers this as a private investment. The most of the countries who made this happen have significantly focused in bringing this as an infrastructure for the country, like roadways, right? Like you have all ports, all power sector, it has to become the infrastructure which is to be largely participated by the government in creating an infrastructure, which is that is something which is still missing today. Second, I see that there is a lot of, I think, disintegrated approach between technology, what they want to push, what's need for country, and the speed at capacities are getting created. I think Mr. Sridhar spoke about what they're trying to do is enormous. And they're doing about 500 kilometers, 600 kilometers a day. We are trying to catch up and say, can we do 100 kilometers? I can tell you it's a nightmare experience. And it's not possible. It's not just maths on paper. It's real-time experience, and it's difficult to work, to even to do a 10 kilometer per day in an Indian context. There are so many challenges. I think it's important to, while appreciate whatever happened so far, I think I don't want to take disregard about what government is doing, what large telcos are doing. All the policies are before us, and DCP is before us. It has really set a good direction. I think it's a good vision for the industry at par with any other developed countries. Same as I think some other telcos are actually really disruptive way of creating networks. And we find that new networks are also being built. That's a story where it is very, very important to look at next 20 years. What is going to be before us? And everyone talking about data is going to drive the network creation. But what kind of data is going? We saw some interesting presentation from how big data is actually making lives changing experiences, how we can actually look at those. So it is very important that the consumers and industry trends are actually changing. You find that sooner, I think all consumers will be start demanding 8K video demand experiences. People would like to have an excellent home broadband experience. People want to have virtual reality. People want to have artificial intelligence. And on the industry segment side, we find that M2M, I find industry 4.0, these are going to come in a long way. And so as I think while this is happening, we are seeing that interestingly, both telco segment, even the OTT segment, which is coming up as a parallel to telcos, both are actually looking at creating a new networks of future, which are not actually experienced by India for last 20 years. So there is a bigger complexity even to add to what we are talking about digital infrastructure, because future network cannot be only wireless. It is to be fiber dominant, it has to be moving from a proprietary hardware to open source, and it will be a lot on the software-driven control. So what we are adding is, apart from the network scale, we are adding actually the complexity. Complexity in terms of latency required, complexity instead of agility of networks. So if you put this problem to, before all of us, the digital infrastructure, we all know what impact can create. But I think we need to understand the task before us, that if you are to make this reality to happen, there is, I think, a lot of work that we need to do together. Go back to drawing board again. I think I must appreciate what Broadband India Forum is actually taking initiative and taking lead in terms of actually bringing some of the thoughts which are actually very important today for the next generation to live up to that expectations. But having said that, we are in a good time today. Reason is that when 2G was being built, I think it was only 2G, 3G. There is no thought about what is the future needs of actually consumers are. People never thought that somebody like Jio will come and actually disrupt the data usage requirements. And people, telecom companies are actually becoming a data network companies today, data application companies. There is a whole paradigm shift happening today. I think we never knew that in 5 years, 10 years ago. But today we are fortunate that we are in an era where we know what the future generation needs are. And in terms of all statistics are before us. I think that is something which is very, we're very fortunate to be in that state of mind today to really design, create this digital infrastructure. Because digital infrastructure of standards that we built for last 20 years in the country will of no use. Because if it doesn't serve the purpose, ultimately, all the big impact that we're talking about economic development will not happen. It's just going to be, because it has to be put to use, because we have seen many programs in the country ultimately don't achieve the maximum utilization of the network because the design, the way we implement networks in the country has to change. I think that's one thing which is very important is all these things will happen only when you get technologies. I think we believe a 5G or a 4G is largely hindering on fiber backhaul. Without fiber, 5G, 4G doesn't work, doesn't exist. And it is go together. And you're talking about broadband experience of whatever speeds we wanted to get, it is again fiber. You're talking about smart cities, if they have to really play a role, it has to be on fiber backhaul. If you wanted industry 4.0, it has to be fiber backhaul. So if you look at everything around, it actually goes back and say basic infrastructure, digital infrastructure lies on something India could not live up to in creating and maintaining for last 15 years. So there is a mammoth task for us. I think this is something which I always say that we have a larger vision of financial inclusion. Many people talked about how do we actually impact countries' larger financial inclusion, which is happening at micro level, at macro level. I think this infrastructure is going to be very critical for the for all of us to focus, even to implement such large programs. So I leave the thought here that if this digital infrastructure is our future dream, I think we all require to do a different way to engage, both from industry, which is telco, which is internet content providers, the way I think they look at building networks, the way they actually look at what designs, what networks they need to build has to be far-sighted rather than current thought process. Of course, Jio is leading that thought. And also, I think moving from almost like we're not a telecom companies anymore. We just need to move to a digital companies, which is much far better expectation. And also industries like us, the partners like us need to really bring technologies. This digital infrastructure in the country won't happen if I had to live up to what Mr. Sridhar said. It won't happen by digging roads in the same way which we have been for 10 years. There has to be large inclusion of technologies in this network creation. So partners like us and many people have to play that role. Important role I expect from government would be good work being done in the policy creation. I say the converting national telecom policy into national digital communication policy thought itself is a transformational, because adding digital communication to usual communication network itself is a very thought-provoking idea. But putting a capital outlay to that is important. Expecting everything to happen from private, it's unfortunately that Indian, in the only thing that telecom doesn't have any budget allocation from the government of India, where every sector in the country in infrastructure get good attention. I think it requires rethought. It requires introspection at decision-making level to see if you are to really deploy NDCP, you need to have a 5-year capital outlay, which is government funded. It's not USFR anymore. It is need to be government, need to come into action. I think more important thing is regulatory. I think ease of doing business, as Mr. Amitabh Khan said. I think we still, if this infrastructure it has to be a dream for us, in India, deploying this kind of, I think we need about 5 million kilometers of cable network to see what we want to do in the next 5 years. Is that possible? It's possible. Just we need to make sure projects in India are delivered with good governance and ease of doing business. I think a long way to go because India is still about 100th rank in ease of doing business. Even if you achieve 50th rank, I hope this dream will happen. So thank you very much for giving me this opportunity on speaking on this.
Thank you, Mr. Rao.